In all the years that Skipper Bob Killick was magistrate along the shore, the shrewdest piece of court work he had to handle was the time when Uncle Sol Noddy stole the two holes from Skipper Lige Bartle. Now, what good, you might say, is two holes? Not much nowadays, since most people give up keeping dogs. But years ago, well, how else can a man set a heron net under the ice? You cut two holes 8 or 10 foot apart, tie a rope to one end of a flake lunger, poke it down through one hole, and hook it up through the other with a hand gaff. Oh yes, if you want to set a bigger net, you cut 3 holes, or even 4. But 2 holes was enough to serve Skipper Lige Bartle's purpose that evening he was coming home down the arm on dog team from his rabbit slips. He chopped his 2 holes, then hurried home to get his net and a flake lunger, so as to have it set and home again afore night overtook him. He didn't even stop for a bite to eat, just grabbed a pair of dry cuffs and was off again, a spry man. But spry as he was, Uncle Sol Noddy was spryer. Uncle Sol was already there and had just finished setting his net in Lige's holes. Well, Lige ordered Sol to take that net out of his holes. Sol said they was his, 'cause he'd found them. Lige said they was his 'cause he chopped them. Well, Sol said be that as it might, he owned them now 'cause possession was 9 points of the law. Skipper Lige was a younger man than Uncle Sol, and a bigger man. And if he hadn't been a church-going man besides, he said after as how he'd a tied Uncle Sol to his own rope and reeved him down one hole and up through the t'other. As it was, he went home and he wired Skipper Bob Killick, the magistrate, to come immediately, or a bit quicker than that, if 'twas possible. Skipper Bob wired back that he'd come and have court work in May, when navigation opened. Public opinion was one-sided. Skipper Lige was a respectable man, whereas Uncle Sol was the worst miserable hangy shore on the coast. And to make matters worse, Sol was doing real well with the heron, and even offered Skipper Lige a meal for his Good Friday dinner. I can't repeat Skipper Lige's answer, but it made him feel so low that he didn't have the face to go to church on Easter Sunday. Well, Pigeon Inlet School was packed for court work when Skipper Bob Killick come on his rounds in May. And he read out the charge how Uncle Sol had stolen the property of Skipper Lige, namely and to wit, 2 holes. Then Uncle Sol, instead of having the common decency to confess what he'd done and take what was coming, had the impudence to look the magistrate right square in the face and say he didn't know whether he was guilty or not. And what he would like to know was, what was the law concerning holes? Well, Skipper Bob was took right aback for a minute, and he said he allowed the law concerning holes was like the law concerning anything else. You mustn't steal them. Then Uncle Sol, brazener than ever, asked how could you steal a hole anyway? And when Skipper Bob said what did he mean, how could you steal a hole? Uncle Sol said, 'cause a hole, well a hole was nothing anyway. Only a hole. All this time poor Skipper Lige was there saying nothing, but swelling up like a gurnet, ready to bust. Then he said as how a hole might be nothing to the hangy shore that stole it, but 'twas something to the man that had to chop it. But Skipper Bob called into order. So Lige kept quiet, but he swelled bigger, if that was possible, until Skipper Bob ruled that on his first point, Uncle Sol had lost out, and a hole was something. All right then, said Uncle Sol, I only borrowed the use of his holes, never intending to keep them, and now we can have them back again. Skipper Lige said the holes was drove out the bay when the ice went out, but Uncle Sol maintained that holes was only fresh air and water, and they were still up there in the arm, and Lige could have them and 10,000 welcomes. Well, Skipper Bob had to call a 15-minute recess on that. But after it was over, he come back and he ruled as how Uncle Sol was wrong, on account of how, in what he called common law, a hole couldn't be a hole unless there was a hedge around him. Then Uncle Sol tried his last dodge. He said as how a man couldn't steal anything without shifting it from where he'd found it in the first place, and that he hadn't shifted these holes an inch. Skipper Lloyd said no, Sol hadn't shifted them, not cause he wouldn't, but cause he couldn't. And if he could have, he'd have slung the two holes over his back quick enough and gone off with them. Uncle Sol said, be that as it might, the fact was he hadn't shifted them. And on that point, Skipper Bob Killick, the magistrate, had to agree with him. He gave his verdict that although Uncle Sol hadn't actually stole the holes, he had trespassed on them. And he asked Uncle Sol what he had to say before a sentence was passed. Well, Uncle Sol said right cheerful-like that if all he'd done was to trespass against Skipper Lodge, no doubt Skipper Lodge, as a church-going man, would be only too ready to forgive those, including Uncle Sol, who had trespassed against him. And Skipper Lodge bust right out then for sure. And he said he'd forgive Uncle Sol when Uncle Sol give him back his holes, edges and all, and with that, Skipper Bob delivered his judgment. He ordered Uncle Sol to cut two holes the following winter, in the same place, for Skipper Lodge to set his errand net in. And that was the end of it as far as the law was concerned. Of course, Uncle Sol got the best of it in the long run, but that's another story. And like Skipper Bob, his own self, said the following summer, after he'd heard the outcome, he doubted very much if even the Supreme Court could do much to cure a hangishore like Uncle Sol Noddy. Cause he was one miserable hangishore, if ever there was one.